voice and said unto them, You men of Judea, and all that dwell at Jerusalem, be this known unto you, and hearken to my words, for these are not drunken as you suppose. See, it is but the third hour of the day, that this is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel, and it shall come to pass that in the last day, said the Lord, I shall pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 And when the day of Pentecost was fully come. Amen.
Amen.
That's why we call ourselves Pentecostals. Amen.
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 Because the Holy Spirit fell upon the disciples on the day of Pentecost. Amen?
Amen.
But the day of Pentecost had nothing to do with the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Now, Father, we are telling Abu Ruka, we are heroes. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It was just a holiday. Amen. It was a festival. Amen.
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 You know, we have got this festival of the Passover and other festivals. Amen.
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 But every, if you see in the Bible, every festival in the Old Testament was replaced in the New Testament. Amen. Amen?
Amen.
That's why the day of the festival of the Pentecost now has been replaced by the coming of the Holy Spirit. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when we remember Pentecost, we don't remember that festival. We remember the coming of the Holy Ghost. Amen?
Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
And this was by design. Amen? Hallelujah.
Amen.
It was not a mistake. It was by what? By design. Because Christ is saying, I come to replace the old. Amen? With the new. Amen? So everything that stood in the old had to be replaced with the new. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So this one, we're coming in season. Amen. But the first one was the Passover. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, the Passover, as we know it from Exodus chapter 12, the almost father put up the Israelites. But he put this one on the wall as he's like a Pharaoh. Amen? Hallelujah. Where the firstborns of everyone of Egypt were dying. Amen? Hallelujah. But there was something that had been said. It was said, you take a lamb. Amen?
Amen.
And when you kill it, eat it with the family. Amen? Find another family where you share it. Amen? And eat. And take the blood and put it on the post of your doors. Amen?
Amen.
So that when the angel comes, when he identifies this blood, he will not kill the firstborn in that house. Amen? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 So it was for the saving of the people of Israel. Amen. Being selected from those of Egypt and those of God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There had to be a difference between those of God and those of Pharaoh. Amen.
Amen.
And that difference was the blood of the lamb. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the disciples asked Jesus at one point and said, you are saying, you are leaving us and you will give us the Holy Spirit. How would you identify between those of the world and us? Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But our difference now, this one was blood of the lamb. But at this new Passover now, it is the blood of Jesus. Amen?
Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
That's why Jesus says, take this cup, drink it. It is my blood. Amen?
Amen.
Of the new covenant. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Meaning we are replacing that one of Moses with another covenant. Amen?
Amen?
That when you remember God saving his people, you remember with my dying, not with the killing of the lambs. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So Christ became the Passover. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you read well, in verse 46, it says, when you eat that lamb, do not break its bones. Amen?
Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The bones of that lamb were to remain intact. Amen?
Amen?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But if you read John 19, it says, when they discovered that Christ had died, when they came to collect the body, none of his
So it's saying the killing of the goats, the lambs, and the what was of Moses. Amen? But in the new season, we are being saved through the dying of Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 And it says to the next Passover, after the Passover, there was this of the feast of the unleavened bread. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, the issue of the unleavened bread, when these people were supposed to be leaving the next morning, they were to bake bread, and it was to be baked very fast. Amen?
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 Amen.
Because there was no time. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So there was no time to put yeast and wait it for to whatever, multiply and inflate. Amen? So they baked without the what? The yeast. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 So they remembered that time. Amen?
Amen?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why Christ comes in and says, I am that bread now. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I am that what? Bread now. Amen. Amen. That's why he says to Judas, you, whatever you're doing, do it fast. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because this bread was to be prepared with speed. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. The same way it was prepared back in Egypt, it was prepared with speed. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. And Judas says, whatever I'm going to do it with speed. Amen?
Amen?
Hallelujah. As we go to offer his what? His body. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 So now, that's why he says, I am the bread of life. Amen. These ones remembered the bread from Egypt. Amen. That sustained them until they would receive the manna. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he says now, in this season, I am the bread of life. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Whoever partakes of this one is taken of the bread of life. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, him being the bread of life, saying, whoever receives me shall not lack. Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then the third season was the season of the first fruit. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Was the season of the what?
First
fruit. Amen. So with the first fruit, what will happen when the first harvest, amen, you would bring your first harvest to what? To the temple of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You see, I love something about these people. These were called feasts, but people were coming to give to God. Amen. Meaning they were, when they were giving to God, it was a feast to them. They were doing it with joy. Amen?
Yes.
Hallelujah. So everyone would bring their branch of grapes, their branch of wheat, their branch of what? And they would celebrate waving everything to the Lord. Thank you, God, for giving us this. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, when you come to give to God, you are thanking Him for what He has given you. Amen? So you should be doing it with joy. Amen? Because every giving is thanksgiving. Amen? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But when it comes to Christ now, he says he is the firstborn of the resurrection. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So he was the first fruit according to the dead. Amen? The resurrection of the dead. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So what they will do now is before they go to Pentecost now, they would combine the Passover in the first fruits. Amen?
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 Amen.
Hallelujah. This is 7 days before we combine the Passover and the first fruits. Amen?
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 Amen.
And when they get to the first fruits now, it was what we call the Pentecost now. Amen? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
7 days to celebrate the Passover. After the Passover, the first fruits, after the first fruits, you go to Pentecost. Amen?
Amen.
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 Pentecost was the celebration of the harvest now. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Pentecost was the celebration of the what? Of the harvest itself. Amen.
Amen.
And this thing would go on for weeks and weeks. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. People celebrating what God has done for them. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Watch and learn. Amen?
Amen.
Amen?
Amen?
So that when you claim those scriptures, you understand where it's coming from. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. This is where it starts. Amen. You know, Joel 1, it starts with people mourning. Amen. That there was a poor harvest. Amen. There was no grazing for their animals. Amen. Amen. So everyone was crying. But the day of Pentecost or the weeks of Pentecost had to be celebrated whether there was harvest or no harvest. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So in Joel chapter 2, people come together in the time of Pentecost, but this time they are not celebrating. Amen?
Amen.
They are mourning that we don't have anything to celebrate to God. It has been a drought. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. So Joel addresses the people and says, if you come together and repent to this God, amen,
amen.
Hallelujah,
amen.
You will forgive your sins, amen,
amen,
amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah,
amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then when we get to the 27 that we all want, amen, you know, I will replace everything that was destroyed, amen,
amen.
I will replace